And tensions are also running high at another Capitol Hill hearing today. This one focuses on the threat of terrorists recruiting new fighters in American prisons. This is a huge of interest story for all of us who care about terrorism in this country. Now, one of the congressmen who's taking issue with the spotlight being placed only on Muslim inmates had this to say about this. Listen.
What I disagree with, and I would say again with all due respect to the chairman, is the scope of this committee's only focusing on one particular group. I actually believe that the focus of one particular group on the basis of race or religion can be deemed as racist and is discriminatory.
The fact is, we are not going to spread ourselves out, investigate everything, which means investigating nothing. We're going to focus on a target which threatens the security of this nation, and that's why we are doing it without in any way minimizing the other threats. We have committees for that.
All right, and the Congressman Peter King, the chair of the Homeland Security Committee, who you just heard, joins us now. Congressman, welcome. Good to see
you. Thank you, Martha.
All right, this is the second round of these. You got a lot of backlash the first time around, and there have been more protests to this the second time. What addressed the issue that was brought up in that clip that we just played? Why not talk about all the different groups that could possibly present a threat in their U.S. prison system?
First of all, the Homeland Security Committee was established to fight terrorism. And what we are focusing on is terrorist agents in this country. And right now, there is an attempt, a serious attempt, to radicalize Muslim Americans in prison and turn them into jihadists. No one is minimizing the other gangs, the Crips, the Bloods, any of those gangs. We have other committees to do that. Our committee was set up specifically to target terrorism. And the only group in prison which is tied with overseas terrorists, which is part of an existential threat the United States, are radical Islamist Muslims. And that's why, that is why this hearing is focused on them. It's not to say the other gangs aren't important or more a serious threat, but no one is more of a threat than radical Islamists.
Yeah, I mean, you make an excellent point. You know, we know that we can trace some of these activities back to radical Islamists, some of whom who have been proselytized to in prison. It's a cultivating breeding ground. Give us some of the specific examples for why you believe that this is such a concern. And tell everybody at home, you know, are people within the prison system, do they have what they need to combat this?
No, they really don't. For instance, in New York, we've had Muslim chaplains who have been convicted of smuggling razor blades into the prisoners in the jail. And that Muslim chaplain turns out to have been a convicted murderer, yet he was approved to be a Muslim chaplain. We had the Newberg Four, who just got out of prison several years ago. They're radicalized in prison. While they're in prison, this conspiracy was hatched. Then after that, they followed up at a local mosque, and they attempted to bomb a synagogue and attack Stewart Air Force Base
in
New York.
Talk to me about, you know, so what kind of screening system do people have to go through in order to work in these prison systems? It's unbelievable when you mention a chaplain who, you know, snuck in a razor blade to help, Muslim convicts escape. It's an incredible story.
Well, not just a razor blade, a whole bag of razor blades he brought in. No, the problem is there is no serious vetting operation because the Muslim community does not have, like, theological seminaries. There is no board who can sign up. Anyone can say he's an imam. Anyone can try to qualify to be a chaplain. And because of political correctness, we've allowed people who are convicts themselves sit on the boards to decide who the chaplain is. In the prison, a group of prisoners can select their own imam, and they get certain rights and privileges. We have cases where Muslim chaplains are allowing prisoners to make telephone calls overseas to overseas radical groups and accept phone calls back in.
It's your contention that they're getting privileges that other prisoners are not getting, and that those privileges are allowing them to carry out this activity behind those prison walls. Peter King, Congressman from New York, Chairman of the House Homeland Security Committee, we thank you very much.
Martha,
we'll be
thank
watching
you.
With great interest.